الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد Welcome to the first lesson of النحو الواضح في قواعد اللغة العربية للمرحلة الابتدائية And the author, the two authors of this book one is علي الجارم and the other is مصطفى أمين they were both from Egypt and they were contemporaries. They were around in the 40s and 50s, I believe. So they wrote a series of books called Al-Nahu Al-Waadih. So Al-Nahu is Al-Nahu, the grammar, and Al-Waadih means, what does Al-Waadih mean?
Clear.
Clear, yeah, so al-nahu al-wadih, the clear grammar. Yeah, and في قواعد اللغة العربية, in the rules or the قواعد of the Arabic language. It says للمرحلة الابتدائية, for the ابتدائية level. So it's, they wrote it for the ibtidai, the school's level, right? But it's also a very good book for non-Arabs learning Arabic, and you might have been doing books like bayna yadayk or kitab al-asasi. It's a good next step, you know, to do alongside your to do alongside your studies with bayna yadayk or kitab al-asasi, things like this. It's very strong on grammar, and it's also, it also has, as I mentioned, very rich language. Okay, so do we have any other questions before we start?
No, not for me.
Okay, Allah. Okay, so we'll read, this is just the authors, their introduction. Okay, so the first lesson, he starts off with الجملة المفيدة, a useful sentence, a sentence that is beneficial. And I'll let you read from here, then I'll guide you as you're reading, inshallah. So he's going to talk about what is a good sentence, what is an acceptable sentence in the Arabic language. Yeah, so he says al-amthila, he's going to give some examples, and then it's al-bahth, he's going to explain the concept, and then he's going to summarize the qawaid, right? And then there's lots of exercises. Yeah, so some exercises we will do in class, some I ask you to do in your own time so you can think about it, and then we'll look at it in the next lesson. Okay, so we'll read from here. Read this one.
Al-bustanu jamilun. Al-bustanu jamilun.
Al-bustanu jamilun. Read. And the next one.
Al-shamsu tali'atu.
طالعةٌ
طالعةٌ شم علي وردة
يا عليٌ
عليٌ وردة قد قذف محمد زهرة يعيش السمك في الماء يكثر نخيل في المصر
يكثر النخيل في مصر.
في مصر.
Okay, good. Right. What about words? Yeah. Do you understand all the words, the meaning of the words?
The first one says bustan jamila, a good garden.
Yeah, so al-bustan is garden, right?
Yeah.
And al-jamilun is beautiful.
Beautiful.
Good. And the next, so the garden is beautiful.
The garden is beautiful.
The next one.
Al-shamsu, the sun, dali'atun. Is it rising?
No, dali'atun is the yes, you're right. You mean in rising? Yeah, the sun has risen, or the sun is rising.
Okay.
Yeah, طالعة. Or طلعت الشمس. Okay, so الشمس طالعة. Okay. What about the next one? Any words here?
Shama is what?
Is to smell.
Okay, then. Shama aliyun wurdatun. Ali is smell a flower.
Okay, good. So warda. Shama is a verb, which is to smell. Ali is Ali.
Name, yeah.
And wardatun is a flower.
Flower.
Okay, next one.
Radafa Muhammadun zahratun.
Do you understand the meaning?
No, radafa, I don't know.
Qatafa is to pick. Yeah, we need to pick a flower.
Okay.
So Qatafa,
Muhammad picked a flower, yes.
Muhammad picked a zahra, a flower.
Yeah.
Warda
is a rose.
Is a rose. Yeah, and zahra is a flower.
Okay.
Okay, the next one.
يعيش السمك في الماء. The fish lives in the water.
جيد. Yeah, so يعيش is from معاشة. معاشة. يعيش. Yeah, it's from to live. Yeah. So يعيش السمك. السمك is your fish. Feed in an الماء is water. Okay. And then number six.
يكثر نخيل في مصر. نخيل.
نخيل is palm trees.
Palm tree. Then the palm tree. Is many in the country of Masr.
جيد. So يكثر النخيل. So palm trees are increasing in Egypt.
Okay.
Okay, good. Okay, so these are the examples. Let's try to read the explanation. You might find it a little bit hard, but we'll go line by line and we'll try to understand it, inshallah. You, and then we'll summarize it at the end.
Okay, inshallah. إِذَا تَأْمَنَّا التَّرْكِيبَ التَّرْكِيبَ الْأَوَّلَ وَجَدْنَاهُ تَرْكَبُ فِي تَرْكَبُ مِنْ كَلَمَتَيْنِ.
Okay, Jay, so إِذَا تَأَمَّلْنَا إِذَا تَأَمَّلْنَا التركيب الأول وجدناه يتركب من كلمتين. If we look at the this one, تأمل. تأمل is to reflect. فإذا تأملنا, if we reflect التركيب الأول on the first tarkib. So this is a tarkib. Yeah. وَجَدْنَاهُ, we will find it, يَتَرَكَّبُ, it's made, it built up with مِن كَلِمَتَيْن, from two words. Yeah, is that okay?
Yeah. إِحْدَاهُمَا بُسْتَانٌ وَثَانِيَةٌ جَمِيلٌ. The first one is بُسْتَانٌ, which is the garden. وَثَانِيَةٌ, the second one, جَمِيلٌ, the word beautiful.
جَيِّد.
فإذا أخذنا الكلمة الأولى وحدها وهي.
So, فإذا أخذنا الكلمة الأولى وحدها وهي, if we were to take the first word by itself, البستان, this one.
Yeah.
البستان. Let's see what he says.
لم نفهم إلى معنى
إلا معنى
مفردا لا يكفي للتخاطب.
Good. So he's saying if we were to take the Al-Bustanu by itself, لم نفهم. Yeah, we won't understand except for its singular meaning. And it's not enough to speak with. Right? If I just came to you and I said, Al-Bustanu, Al-Bustanu, right? You wouldn't understand what I'm talking about. I'm just saying, garden, garden. Yeah?
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Or carry on.
وَذَلِكَ الْحَالُ إِذَا أَخَذَنَا الكلمة الثانية وحدها وهي جميل. Likewise, if we take the second word alone, which is جميل, ولكن إذا ضممنا إحدى الكلمتين.
Yeah, so, okay, good. So, you said it right. So, if you were to take the second one, Jamilun, by itself, it wouldn't have much meaning. It does have a meaning, the word has a meaning, but it's not enough for takhatub. Takhatub is to speak, from khitab. Okay, so, ولكن إذا ضممنا إحدى الكلمتين إلى الأخرى على النحو الذي في التركيب, but if you were to put them together in a تركيب, and then carry on, وقلنا
البستان جميل,
البستان جميل,
فهمنا معنى كاملا, we understood the complete meaning, was tough. وَاسْتَفَدْنَا فَائِدَةُ تَامَّةً.
Yeah, وَاسْتَفَدْنَا فَائِدَةً تَامَّةً. And we will take the full فائدة from it.
وَهِيَ
اتصاف الْبُسْتَانِ.
اتصاف الْبُسْتَانِ بالجمال.
Yeah, so what is the sentence trying to say? It's describing ittisaf. Yeah, وَهِيَ اتِّصَافُ الْبُسْتَانِ بِالْجَمَالِ. It's a description of the garden with beauty.
وَلِذَلِكَ يُسَمَّى هَذَا تَرْكِيبُ جَمِيلَةً مُفِيدَةً.
جُمْلَةً مُفِيدَةً.
جُمْلَةً مُفِيدَةً.
وَلِذَلِكَ يُسَمَّى. And this is why we call this tarkib jumla mufida. It's a beneficial, useful sentence.
Okay.
Carry on.
وَكُلُّ وَاحِدَةٍ مِنَ الْكَلِمَتَيْنِ تَعُدُّ جُزْءًا مِنْ هَذِهِ الْجُمْلَةِ.
Carry on.
وهكذا يقال في أمثلة الباقية وبهذا نرى أن الكلمة وحدها لا تكفي في التخاطب وأنه لا يبت.
Oh, good. So every word is considered a juz, a part of this sentence, of this jumla. Yeah, so this is a juz. It is a part of it, right? These are in parts. Shamma aliyun wardatan. Okay, so this one, ya'ishu samaku fil ma'i. So every single word is considered a juz of that kalima. So when we have a jumla mufida, we can take the full kind of meaning from it, and it's takfil al-takhatub. It's enough to kind of speak with and someone to understand you.
Okay.
But a word itself, it doesn't. It's not enough to hold a conversation with. Okay, let's carry on a little bit. وأنه
وأنه لا يب وأنه لا لا بد من كلمتين فأكثر حتى يستفيد الإنسان فائدة تامة.
Yeah, وأنه لا بد. لا بد من like a must. Yeah, وأنه لا بد من كلمتين فأكثر. So we have to have two words at least or more, حتى يستفيد الإنسان فائدة تامة. So the person can have a full grasp of what we are saying. Yeah. وأنه لا بد من كلمتين. There must be two words or more.
وأما نحو قم اجلس تكلم مما ظاهره أنه كلمة واحدة كافية في التخاطب فليس في الحقيقة بكلمة واحدة.
Did you understand that? Try to explain.
Okay. وَأَمَا نَحُو is grammar.
So here, where were you? وَأَمَا نَحُو. So nahu, what does it mean linguistically? It just means like something similar.
Okay.
So here it's not talking about the grammatical term, the istilahi term, and nahu, which you say means grammar. Nahu also means wa amma nahu, and as for things like qum, as for words like قم
stand up
تكلم
yeah.
Good. قم is stand up اجلس sit تكلم speak. So these are what are these examples of
one words that make meaning. Yeah,
yes, but what is this word اجلس? The اسم فعل حرف
فعل.
Oh, good. But what yes. kind of فعل?
Command.
Command, good. What do you call it in Arabic? فعل فعل أمر.
Yeah.
جيد. Okay. So you say مما ظاهره أنه كلمة واحدة. So from the apparent, it looks like one word. Right. But فليس في الحقيقة. ليس في الحقيقة بكلمة واحدة. In reality, it's not actually one word. وإنما هو جملة مركبة من كلمتين. It's a sentence that is made up, that is built up with two words. إحداهما ملفوظا. Period. إحداهما.
إحداهما ملفوظا وهي قم مثلا والأخرى غير ملفوظة وهي أنت التي يفهمهما
يفهمها
يفهمها السامع من الكلام وإن لم ينطق بها.
Good. Okay, did you understand this? Try to explain.
إحداهما ملفوظا. It is telling us that there are two. Here we have the person, subject and the object. Well, the person, one person is saying the command قم, and the والأخرى the other one is the person. The word is composed of two. It's قم. There is a hidden ant. Use it.
Yes.
So the other person then understands what the command is saying, and he does the action.
جيد. Yeah. So when we are saying تكلم, اجلس, when you do think of فعل أمر, there's a hidden أنت there. So أنت قم. Yeah. قم أنت. تكلم أنت. But you, if I tell you, يا حسين اقرأ, اقرأ, you will understand I'm telling you. You read.
Yes.
Yeah. So one is ملفوظ, it is straight from the tongue, and the other is غير ملفوظ, غير ملفوظة.
Okay.
You know, it's not said with the tongue.
It's a verbal and or an hidden one. Eh?
Yes. So التي يفهمها السامع, but you understand, right, من الكلام, وإن لم ينطق بها, even if it's not pronounced. Okay.
Good.
Okay, good. So any questions from here?
No, so far I'm getting it. Thank you.
Okay, good. Allah, so here we have the al-qawa'id. So here he summarizes the qa'ida. So let's read this.
التركيب الذي يفيد فائدة تامة يسمى جميلة
يسمى جملة
جملة جملة جملة فائدة جملة فائدة
جملة مفيدة
جملة مفيدة ويسمى أيضا كلاما
ويسمى أيضا كلاما
أيضا كلاما.
التركيب الذي يفيد فائدة تامة تركيب. Yeah, تركيب is when you have two or more words. التركيب الذي يفيد فائدة تامة, which gives us a full meaning, full beneficial meaning, يسمى, it is called جملة مفيدة. It's called جملة مفيدة. ويسمى أيضا, it's also called كلام. Okay. The next one.
الجملة المفيدة تتركب من كلمتين.
So تركب يتركب. Yeah, so this means to get two things and put it together. تركب. يتركب. So he's saying تتركب من كلمتين. الجملة المفيدة قد تتركب من كلمتين. So there's a minimum of two words. جملة مفيدة has to be built up with a minimum of two words. من كلمتين وقد تتركب Yeah, just indicating maybe built with two words. فَقَدْ تَتَرَكَّبُوا مِنْ أَكْثَرُ. Or it may have more than two words. وَكُلُّ كَلِمَةٍ فِيهَا تُعَدُّ جُزْءًا مِنْهَا. And every word, yeah, is in it is considered a juz'an minha, a part of it. Okay, any questions here?
No, so the word tarakkab,
yeah,
is it a phrase or a sentence?
So this is a fi'l.
Fi'l.
Yeah, this is your fi'l maadi, tarakkaba. And then you have fi'l mudari' yatarakkabu. Yeah, it's just basically to build up.
Composition, is a composed of, maybe.
Composed of, yeah, is a better translation here.
Okay.
Yeah, to compose something of. With yes. More than one thing. وَقَدْ تَتَرَكَّبُوا مِنْ أَكْثَرُ. Or it may be composed of more than
two. Yeah.
More than two. وَكُلُّ كَلِمَةٍ فِيهَا تُعَدُّ جُزْءًا مِنْهَا. So every kalima is considered a juz. It's important. He's saying that for a reason, because he, in the next chapter, he will explain the أَجْزَاءُ الْكَلِمَةِ the أَجْزَاءُ الْجُمْلَةِ. The juz. You have juz, the plural is ajza. Okay, the parts of a sentence. Okay, so then we have tamrinat. The what's the singular of tamrinat? You know, what is it? You go ahead.
At Tamir?
At Tamreen. Tamreen.
Tamreen.
So, Tamreen. Tamreenat. So these are just exercises that will help you understand the concept, inshallah. So he says, اقرأ الأمثلة السابقة. Read the previous examples. وَبَيِّنْ عَدَدَ الْكَلِمَاتِ فِي كُلِّ مِثَالٍ. And explain the number of the words, word numbers in every example. But you can do that in your own time, just to save time. Just look at the sentence. And they're showing, trying to teach you the tarkib min kalimataini aw akthar. Yeah. And then, الثاني, let's do this. Read the.
اقرأ الجملة الآتية وبين الكلمات في كل واحدة منها.
So this is bayin. So bayyana yubayyinu bayyin yeah to explain or to make clear yeah this is a fi'l amr. So he's just instructing you, the author is just instructing you. اقرأ الجمل الآتية وبين الكلمات في كل واحدة منها. Okay. Let's come back to this one just to save time. So this is just you're looking at each word and explaining the meaning.
Yeah.
Yeah. So let's do this, actually. There's a lot of nice words here.
I start reading.
Yeah, go on.
السماء ممطرة
ممطرة
ممطرة الحديقة جميلة.
Okay. Let's go one by one. السماء okay. ممطرة. Okay, so what does that mean?
The word mumtira, is it raining?
Raining, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so as-sama'u mumtiratun. So as-sama' is the sky, mumtiratun is raining.
Yeah.
So what is trying to tell you here, is this a jumla mufida? Do you get an understand? If I tell you as-sama'u ya Hussein, as-sama'u mumtira, you know, you understand something from it. You have a complete yes. understanding of what I'm trying to tell you. The sky looks rainy, right?
Yeah.
What about the? So he's just giving you examples of jumla mufida. And then next one, al hadiqa.
Jamilatun, the beautiful garden.
Good. Next one.
Yang qadi'ul mudr.
Mataru.
Mataru.
Yang qati'u is from where? It's from in qata'a. We have in qata'a. Yang qati'u. In qati' is means to cut off. Not cut off when something disconnects or when something stops. Qata'. Okay, so we say yan qati'u al-matar.
So the rain is stopped.
Rain stopped, yeah. So if the line drops, for example, the connection between me and you, what can you say? Say yan qati' al-ittisal. Yeah.
Okay.
Good. Next one.
Yasiru sahaba.
Sahabu.
Yasiru sahabu.
Yeah.
The biographies of the sahaba.
No. So, no. So, sara yasiru is when something moves. Yasiru, when something glides or moves, and the sahab is the cloud.
Okay.
Yeah, so what you're talking about is the sahaba.
Sat.
Sahaba and ashab. Yeah. Yasiru sahab. Okay, next one.
تَضْلُعُ الشَّمْسُ.
Good. And what's the meaning?
The sun is rising.
Good. Yeah. Next one.
تَجِفُ الْأَرْضُ.
Yeah, تَجِفُ الْأَرْضُ.
Yeah, تَجِفُ, I don't know.
It's from جَفَّ. Yajifu. Okay, so it means to dry.
Dry, okay.
Yeah, so after the Sama'u Muntira, then it's Yanqati'u al-Matar, and now the Tajifu al-Ard, the earth is, ground is drying.
Okay.
Next one.
الطائر فوق شجرتي.
Good. الطائر فوق شجرتي. What's the meaning? الطائر.
طائر. Is it a was it a bird or a plane?
A bird. Yeah. فوق شجرتي.
The bird is on top of the tree.
Yeah. The bird is on the tree. Good. Then
yaqdifu aliyun al-azhar.
Jayid, yeah. What's the meaning? Yaqtifu aliyun al-azhara.
Ali took a flaw.
Yeah, so from we talked about before the qatafa. Qatafa yaqtifu. Yeah. Yaqtifu aliyun al-azhara. Next one.
يلعب القلمان بالكرة
الكرة جيد
بالكرة يلعب القلمان بالكرة he plays football. قلمان is a name of a person.
No, غلمان is just a boy. يلعب الغلمان يلعب الغلمان بالكرة.
The boy is playing football.
Yeah, he's not playing. Yeah, football maybe, but just playing with the ball.
With the ball, yeah.
Good. And the next one.
ينزل مطر من السماء.
ينزل. Where does it come from?
أنزل.
نزل. ينزل المطر من السماء.
It is raining.
Yes.
تسير السفن في البحار.
بحار. So بحار is from بحر.
Yeah. سفن is a boat or ship.
Yes. So comes from السفينة. تسير السفن is the plural of سفينة. The ships. Yeah. تسير السفن في البحار. In the
ship. Yeah. They are moving in the ocean.
Yeah. So if you think about the cloud, يسير السحاب.
Yeah.
تسير السفن, it kind of moves the same way. So
yes.
He's talking about this motion.
يشتد البرد فوق الجبال.
What's the meaning of this?
يشتد is something.
Yeah. So it comes from ish tadda, means when something is intense.
Intense. Okay. So the cold on top of the mountain is intense, or
yeah, it's more intense. Maybe ish tadda, ish tadda al bardu, or ish tadda al bardu. It becomes more colder on top of a mountain. Yeah. Good. Okay. That's great. So these are examples of
complete
sentences, jumla, mufida. You know. So it's just giving you an example of it. So now you're gonna go and it says mayyiz al-jumla al-mufida fi al-tarakib al-atiya. Mayyiz means from mayyaza. ميز يميز ميز is to distinguish. الجمل المفيدة to distinguish the جمل المفيدة في التراكيب الآتية. So you have some جمل, or you can call it جمل. You have some examples there that are not jumla mufida. Okay, so he wants you to catch them out. Okay, so let's start with this one.
the first one.
Yeah.
Laysal jawu.
Laysal jawu.
The word jawu is?
So the weather. So jawu means weather.
So there's no weather. This one says there's no weather.
So laysal jawu. So laysal jawu, then what? You're just saying the weather is not.
Okay, there's not. So it's not a complete, yeah.
It's not a complete sentence, no.
It's khada, yeah.
It doesn't give
a complete meaning.
A complete meaning. Good, carry on.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah.
Akul faridun.
Akala faridun.
Akala faridun. Farid it.
Farid eight. All right. Does this give?
Naam.
It is, yeah. But it's telling you something full. He ate something.
Yeah.
So it's just trying to trick you, saying that it does it have to be akala faridun samaka. That would be more complete. But even if you say akala Hussein, yeah, or akalat Kulthum, you know, it gives you enough to understand something.
Understand, yeah.
Carry on.
Al-Qidar Sari'un. What was Qidar?
Qidar is a train. Sari' is fast.
Okay, yeah. Al-Qidar Sari'un. The train is fast. I think this one is also a complete meaning.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
So I said this one is number four.
In ajtihdat.
Ijtahadta.
In ijtahada.
Ijtahada. Yajtahidu. Ijtahid. So ijtahadta is the anta ijtahadta. Anta fa'alta. Or akalta. You understand? So it's the fi'lu madi with the you. Yeah, anta dhahabta. So you're saying ijtahadta. You worked hard. Yeah, or if you worked hard. In is like if here. Yeah. So what do you think?
In ijtahadat, if you worked hard. So yeah. It's missing some parts. It's not making a complete.
Yes, good.
Yeah.
It's not complete. It's not giving us a full meaning. So
the condition, after not working hard, it's not giving us a condition.
Yes.
The consequence.
Right. Yeah. So, it just wants you to feel, you know, is it a jumla mufida or is it not? Okay, Sister Kulthum, you want to do the next column?
Yeah, sir, inshallah. Laythal maridu.
Laytal Marid, okay, good. Is this, do you feel it's complete? Is giving you a full meaning?
No, it's not complete. No. It means there is no sick patient, something. There is no sick.
Yeah, so Laytal Layta is from the Ismu Inna. We'll go through that later.
Okay.
Layta, it just means to wish. Yeah.
Okay.
Laytal Marid. Laytal Marid. So it's not giving a full sentence. That's what's important here.
Yeah. As-sawbu nazifun. The clothes are dirty. The cloth is dirty.
Nazif.
Nazif.
Nazif is the opposite.
Dirty?
No, it's clean.
Clean, yeah. The cloth is clean.
Yeah.
It's a complete sentence.
It's complete. Okay, good. The next one.
Al kitabul lazi. The book which incomplete.
Complete or incomplete?
It's incomplete.
incomplete. Good. Next one.
Al-bintu, al-bintul muta'allima. It's a complete sentence. The girl is a teacher.
Think about it again. Is this saying the girl is a teacher? Well, is this a khabar or a na'at?
Oh, al-bintu al-muta'allima.
The
girl, yeah, muta'allima would be teacher.
So if I said al-bintu muta'allima.
No, it is khabar, mubtada and khabar, whereas here it is na'at and manut.
Al bintu muallima. If I said something like this, and it might make it complete, but here it's just saying the learned girl. And then stopping.
Yeah, I got it. Yeah. It's so incomplete.
It's incomplete, yeah. So, okay, so we'll stop here. We'll do 1 hour, inshallah, and if it goes well. This book is very good. So if it goes well, we'll do more because it'll be beneficial.
Is that what days are the classes? Is it daily?
No, it's just once a week now.
Friday.
If it goes well, we'll do more. We'll finish it because this will really help you to finish your, make your understanding of Bayna Yadayk and Kitab al-Asas in these books. Better, inshallah. So we'll stop here. Jazakumullah khairan. Just don't drop off the call yet. Inshallah.